Hey guys, what is up? It's Dusty here and welcome back to another episode of the Daily Crypto News. And you guys have been requesting it, so today we have a big update on Ripple and XRP. First of all, Ripple is seeing good progress in the SEC case over XRP. An outcome is expected next year. We've actually talked about this specific subject a couple of times on the channel already, which basically revolves around the fact that the Ripple case has to end in 2022. The only question is exactly when, because some people have rightfully so speculated that it might be a smart idea to buy some other crypto in the meantime to then transfer back into XRP a little bit before the deadline or something along those lines. So I'm going to give you guys one reason to agree with that and one reason to very much disagree with that. Here we go. So the one reason to agree is simply because we kind of have a schedule set for the lawsuit. We kind of know the dates at which it's going to end. I've covered all of that over my videos like the last couple of months, so we know a little bit of the schedule. We know the dates, right? Things shifted a little bit, but that's exactly the previous dates which we had plus 2 months. So we kind of know. Then again, the reason not to is actually split up into two. One is you never know if the lawsuit is going to end quote unquote early. And two, even if you do know it's going to end up early, a lot of other people are going to know. So when you're going to try buy in, if you sell now, it could, theoretically speaking, be that the price is going to be double. As I've said, guys, when Ripple got sued, I told everybody, I'm going to make 100 times gains on my XRP when the lawsuit settles, so to speak. I told everybody that. Then again, the price was 17 cents at the lowest point, a couple of days, exactly 1 week, 29th of December, after the lawsuit hit. So from that point of forward, if you bought in at 17 cents, December 29th, the week after the lawsuit, right? The most difficult point to buy into because people's faith was really low. 100x gains, I think, are coming. If you bought later, for example, if you're buying right now, you've already lost out on quite a significant amount of the gains. I still think it's going to go times 12 or so, but of course it's a lot less. And it could be that at the time at which you decide, hey, we're getting close, that the price is going to be triple of what we have right now. Not a certainty, not a guarantee, but there's a good chance around something like that. Ripple's making good progress in its legal feud with the SEC, CEO Brad Garlinghouse said. Garlinghouse expects the case will likely reach a conclusion next year, and the SEC alleges Ripple and its executives sold $1.3 billion worth of crypto, XRP, in an unregistered securities offering. So fintech company Ripple, I hope it didn't switch over to the AirPods, by the way. Ooh, I so hope that not all of a sudden I'm going to be only hearing... so for all of you that are not watching, only listening, a little notification of my AirPods popped up. And what I get very often, guys, I get this so often, is that my microphone during the recording switches off or does something crazy, so I have to re-record the entire episode. Oh, I just hope it didn't happen just now. Let's just hope. All right, so fintech company Ripple is making strides in its legal feud with the SEC. Garlinghouse said he expects the case, which centers on XRP, the world's seventh biggest crypto, will likely reach a conclusion next year. I think it's almost certain. I think like first half of 2022. We're seeing pretty good progress despite a slow-moving judicial process, he told CNBC. Clearly, we're seeing good questions asked by the judge, and I think the judge realized that it's not just Ripple, it's the broader implications. And Garlinghouse said he was hopeful that there would be closure next year. I do think so. Okay, let's actually fix this. Why does this keep happening? All right, there we go. I get scared because of notifications like that. And Garlinghouse said he was hopeful that there would be closure. Ripple was based in San Francisco, generated a lot of buzz during the crypto frenzy in 2017-18, which saw the prices of Bitcoin, Ether, skyrocket. And by the way, at that point, XRP was number two in the crypto realm. A lot of people don't actually know that XRP used to be number two. And right now, guys, in my country here, Garlinghouse said the UAE, Japan, Singapore, and Switzerland are examples of countries showing leadership when it comes to regulating crypto, while China and India have cracked down on the industry. Yeah, actually, I just got some news from India. I just saw this. Breaking Indian government to ban almost all cryptocurrencies. Ooh, that is pretty scary. By the way, guys, I don't have it open right now, but make sure you check out Bybit. A link is down below, as there's a couple of launches on there that are amazing. And I still have a couple of BIT giveaways to do. And right now, there's a couple of really, really cool, as actions where you can get some money for free, basically, which you should check out if you didn't do that yet. But more importantly, for those launch pads, guys, I'm going to be doing so many announcements whenever something goes out on there, because I do believe that is the easiest free way to make money in crypto, at least one of the easiest ways. All you have to do is get yourself an account on Bybit, trade once or so, and get yourself some BIT, which I think is also a pretty good crypto to hold. I'm just kind of putting that out there so I don't forget to say it. And by the way, guys, put down below, are you guys excited about XRP? Yes or no? And make sure you press the like button if you're enjoying these videos. All right, breaking. Indian government to ban almost all crypto. Yeah. They are seeking to prohibit almost all private cryptocurrencies. India's government tracking down a ban on virtually all privately issued cryptos, such as Bitcoin and Ether, according to a bill slated for the winter parliament session. It'll allow for certain exceptions in order to promote technology, as per the bill's agenda, quote, to create a facilitative framework for creation of the official digital currency to be issued by the Reserve Bank of India. The bill also seeks to prohibit all private crypto in India. However, it all allows for certain exceptions to promote the underlying technology of cryptocurrency and its uses. And so I'm not exactly sure what that's supposed to mean, as they are literally saying, hey, well, you know what, we're making some exceptions to promote the blockchain technology, but in crypto as a whole, but then the crypto itself will be banned? Not exactly sure. It says here, only when a coin has been approved by the government can it be traded, else holding or trading it may attract a penalty. So even holding it like that, not even only trading, but even holding it can impose a penalty. That is some heavy stuff. Bitcoin didn't really react to it. At least let's quickly check and to reaffirm. No, Bitcoin didn't really react to it. It could be that some more, I guess, India-centered altcoins might... Holy smokes, crypto.com is going like a freaking beast. Wow, crypto.com, do you guys think it's going to hit a dollar? And look at our man at Decentraland as well. I didn't even check the price. A sandbox at almost $7. Wow, we've quadrupled our money on sandbox. At least tripled our money since the first video like a week ago or two. That is insane. Well, I'm happy. I'm happy to be a metaverse enthusiast because, wow, that is crazy. What an interesting predicament in the crypto space here as well, huh? Where some of our favorite crypto like XRP and Polkadot or Cardano and stuff are going down so much, but some of our, I guess, top picks, except for AVAX, are doing amazing, amazing, amazing. Literally, look at the last video I made. Matic, Mana, Sand, we're all in there, the three of them. I think we also had AVAX in there, so that one didn't do too well, but I guess we have a 3 out of 4. That is some juicy stuff, everybody. That is golden. And of course, guys, I already said, I think we can definitely see a pump going on Sand up until the 28th or so before things might turn around. Oh, yeah, crypto.com was the last one in there. Wow, what a beautiful little couple of days, guys. That is beautiful to see, but we'll talk about that a little bit more later. Let's quickly see about the Ripple XRP stuff for right now, huh? Ripple executive says company's making strong progress in the SEC case and that the outcome might fuel the price. I don't think he really said that too much. He basically just said, hey, we're pretty happy with the way it's going. It's mostly going to resolve at least next year, pretty soon. We have some skepticism towards, you know, Jay Clayton and some of the SEC members, at least that's us XRP community who kind of have some skepticism towards those guys. But most likely there's just, the further it goes, the better the things are looking, the higher the price will go, which is obviously also the scary part about not being involved, I guess, from the get-go, so to speak, or getting in later. Now, David Swartz said this over on Twitter. He's pretty excited about the progress of the XRP ledger. He said, this is awesome news. This change reduces the ledger's vulnerability to halting without any sacrifice in decentralization. So what happened is the negative UNL amendment is now live and active on the XRP ledger, and it's an important amendment that provides resilience for the network with multiple validators are offline. So basically, now when multiple validators are offline, things get a little bit sketchy, or at least the more they go offline, the sketchier it gets. But they made a new change, a new negative UNL amendment that specifically here targets when that happens, as the important amendment provides resilience for the network when they go down. And I'm not exactly sure about the exact details of it, right? But these are juicy updates to have. And the CTO of Ripple and one of the core contributors to the XRP Ledger, co-founders or co-creators, you should say, is also pretty excited about it. So am I. All right. Russia, what's going on? Russian tax services deals with cryptocurrencies. This system of settlements can create a fairly substantial erosion for the tax base, head of service Daniil Egorov stressed. Russian Federal Tax Service is closely dealing with the crypto market because the system of settlements can create a fairly substantial erosion for the tax base, head of the service said in an interview. Speaking about crypto, we are now dealing with the market rather closely, with understanding that this system of payments can create a fairly substantial erosion for the tax base. So I guess we'll see about that one. Technologies on anonymizing are also used to present to avoid taxation from the standpoint of service provisions by various swindlers, the office added. So they're going to crack down on that, which is, I guess, a good thing for legitimacy of crypto. Then again, it might also expose some... I'm not exactly sure if this is good or bad because they're taking good steps in the right direction. Might make it more difficult for crypto companies to step up. Then again, if they're just saying, hey, we're trying to go after money launderers, for example, I don't really see a bad thing behind it, you know? Then on News Bitcoin, the IRS, hey, the most fun party in the world, expects to seize billions of dollars in crypto next year, more than $3.5 billion in crypto seized this year. Yeah, obviously they want to get as much tax as possible. Most likely there's going to be some heavy taxation rules on crypto in the future as well, specific to crypto and more reporting requirements. We already saw the infrastructure bill right now, which makes things awful, but I think those things are going to get way more awful before they're going to get adjusted and made better, because they're going to try to get as much out of it as possible, because the opposition is not as loud as the people for it, so to speak. Now, unluckily, I did not talk enough about Sandbox yesterday. I did do a couple of mentions, and I did tell you guys I'm still excited about Sand to the freaking core. I did buy myself, as you guys saw. I bought more crypto.com, I bought more, just all the coins I talked about in my video yesterday. So just check my channel back. Let me see if I can quickly find it here. On my channel, I just recommend you guys to check it out here. On my channel, oh, it's a different channel. I don't have it in here. Just go to my channel, guys. Let's see. Just go to my channel, my YouTube channel. You'll find on one of my videos that I made yesterday, basically. This is my second channel, the 5-minute crypto one, but I don't have myself in there, unluckily. I don't think. No. All right. So without further ado, I guess let's skip that part. Oh, by the way, I can show you guys Bybit in here, actually. I do have a little thingy for it right there. Bybit, yay. Without further ado, I wanted to say, I did make a video just now about my top altcoins. I'm not talking about the gems, but top altcoins. And in there, I think I mentioned Sand. I mentioned, let's quickly see. I forgot now. Crypto.com, Sand, Avex, I think Mana, and Elrond Gold potentially as well. It was definitely Polygon in that list, and maybe XRP. Maybe that was the list of my favorite crypto. Could definitely be so. But yeah, I'm still pretty bullish on the metaverse coins. And I think everybody who's been watching my channel for a little while can definitely give a little heads up of saying, hey, you know, you're definitely right on the metaverse coins, as they're just popping off. And I keep freaking sharing this. I made like 7, maybe even 12 videos explaining to you guys how metaverse coins are taking over, and we should really heavily get into those. But I didn't expect crypto.com to rally this much, guys. I'm just going to be honest with you. I didn't expect the surge to be this big because of 5 times my money in such a short amount of time, which is really juicy. I'm kind of scared for the come down, as it's a little bit overvalued right now. People are going too crazy. But the partnerships which they have and the buying pressure which there is, yeah. It's also getting listed on more exchanges right now because, of course, many people many companies are seeing the appeal that it's having right now. At first, it was mostly listed on crypto.com itself. It's getting more and more broadened out. It's now also on BITRUE. A link for that is down below. It's also on Huobi. It's all in the places. But damn, that is crazy. That is crazy. That is crazy.